Good morning, everybody. Thank you for joining us here on this beautiful Sunday morning. I hope you have had a fantastic week as we come back. I'm sorry we weren't able to do a broadcast last week. I was out sick and my voice is almost back to where it needs to be. So bear with me a little bit here as we go along. But I don't know if you saw that beautiful full moon that we had a few days ago. Wasn't it absolutely fantastic? This was the strawberry moon. We've been talking about the moons this year as our main theme of the year, and we have this beautiful representation. If you saw the strawberry moon on Tuesday night, you might have seen that beautiful red glow that happened in the sky as well. This is again done by Man in the Moon Metalworks. I think that red glow was absolutely perfect for being a strawberry moon. It really brought out the red juiciness of those ripe strawberries that are happening right now. As we've talked about several different times, the moon names have been developed by the Native Americans, and depending on what part of the country they were in, they came up with many different names for the moons. The moon for June had names like the Rose Moon, because roses are coming into full bloom depending on where you are in the country. Strawberry Moon, which is my favorite name because that's my favorite fruit, and strawberries are definitely becoming ripe in this area. And a lot of the moons that we've been talking about are based off of the names with the Algonquin tribe, which was in the Michigan area, northern North American kind of part of the country. It was also called the Mead Moon and the Hot Moon. So the Hot Moon makes sense because it's starting to get a little bit hot out there. Maybe not hot enough for some of you, but I find it getting pretty hot. I know in Arizona it's been long into the triple digits for a while now. I think they hit around 120 the other day, so I guess it's not too hot here when I think about it. And when they called it the Mead Moon, some might think that means mead. It actually did not. It means meadow, because this is the time of year when we have to start cutting all of those long grasses. And so mead came from the Anglo-Saxon word that actually was referencing the meadow and needing to get out there and tend to the lawns. So wild strawberries are a wonderful symbol for many different things. They're ripe, juicy fruit. They're so sweet on the vine. This is also kind of a double theme today because we just turned the wheel to Litha as well. We had been at Beltane previously, and now we have this beautiful summer solstice, which is coming up on the 20th, actually. Often people will think of the solstices as being on either December 21st or June 21st, but it can actually vary anywhere from the 19th to the 22nd. Usually the 20th or the 21st. It will hit at exactly 8 p.m. Eastern time on June 20th this year, and that is the point at which the day reaches its longest peak for the year. We have the shortest night and the longest day, which really kind of heralds in with this strawberry moon too, because as we come into this longest day of the year, we've talked a lot about how to follow the wheel of the year. And in the beginning of the year, you were doing a lot of planning and preparing, making your goals. Well, now you've been planting your seeds, and this is the height of action as we come into Litha. This is the time where we have the most sunlight that can replenish us and shine down on us, refuel us, regenerate us, and give us the light that we need to complete all of those tasks so that we can reach the goals that we want. Sometimes at Litha, it's important to kind of look back and reflect and decide, the goals that we have, are those the goals that we still want to pursue too? Are those the things that are working in our life? What is working, what isn't working? And kind of take inventory and see what we need to change to make our ability to manifest what our dreams are, to have the ability to create what your vision is and see it happen so you can harvest it as we come into the fall months here. So we are also coming up on June 30th to August 2nd on another Mercury retrograde. Don't be afraid. Mercury retrograde is not a bad thing. It's simply a time to reflect, to look back, it appears as though the planet is going backwards. It's not really. It's an optical illusion, just like it's an illusion to think you have to be afraid of the retrogrades. Instead, it's a time to look back and reflect and reassess your goals to see what's working, what's not working. So you might not want to sign contracts and finalize things, but you do want to look over those things and decide and assess what's working, what didn't work. Dot your I's. Cross your T's, and this is such a perfect time to coincide with this new strong element of summer that's coming in, because as you're coming into that main part of action, that where we're working really hard, we're creating what we want for our goals. Maybe we're learning and studying, or maybe you're out doing things physically, whatever it is that you're doing, where you're creating that action in your life, make sure you're taking the time to reflect and continuously go back and see how the progress is, what's working, what's not, what do you want to change, what do you want to bring into your life. Anytime you're creating a recipe for something, just like you're creating a recipe for your life every day, you want to continually reassess, what new ingredients do you want to add in? What new things do you want to bring in to season your life, to spice it up a little bit? This is a great time to do that with the retrograde, and also with being at the heart of summer, this beautiful time of Litha here. So what a wonderful way to welcome in the summer solstice with having the beautiful full moon beforehand. This is really such a time of action. Sometimes it's about working smarter and not just harder as well. This in the Celtic lore and the more natural ways of the following nature, people would talk about the goddess being brimming with fertility at this time of the year. This is where she's completely fertile, ready to give birth as you come into the next season, which really just represents you with your projects in life. So what are you feeling fertile with? What are you feeling passionate about? What are you ready to release and open up within your life so that you can have the results that you want to see as we come into this harvest fall before you know it, it'll be here. So enjoy these long, wonderful days of summer. At the summer solstice, it's actually the time where after the solstice, so starting on the 21st, 22nd, 23rd, the daylight will become a little bit shorter each day. So you want to really use that as a symbol of maximizing that you're doing what you want to do with your life too. Sometimes it's good to reassess and see if our lives are wanting to take a different turn and figure out where we want to go with things instead. Really listening to what nature kind of directs you towards. Sometimes the universe speaks in really interesting and unusual ways. We just have to tune in and listen into that. So as we turn this wheel, we're really pulling into that height of action, putting our plans into the place. And it's also about balance. If you want to watch our video that we did last year at this time, we talked a lot about balance during these summer equinox and the winter equinox as well. A lot of times people think about balance in the cross-quarter holidays where we have equal light and equal day, but it's still important to maintain all of that as we come into the height of summer too, because yes, it's about action, but it's about balance. A lot of times we'll hear about the beautiful lazy nights of summer too. It's great to relax in the evening on a summer after you've had a long day in the summer. Maybe you have a swing outside, or you can sit on your porch, drink some tea, and really soak in the ability to enjoy the day. Enjoy whatever it is that life has brought to you. Enjoy whatever it is that you're doing, and soak in and really take in what's going on within your life. Sometimes it's surprising turns. Sometimes it's exactly what you're expecting. But really find ways to maintain that balance, even in this height of the time of action. If you want to look into the video that we did a couple years ago about the summer solstice, you'll learn a lot about the older customs. That's when we really talked quite a bit about the Celts and all of those great traditions. But this year I want to talk a little bit more about how strawberries fit into the solstice, because it is the strawberry moon as well. And there are so many, many different types of strawberries. The strawberry itself is actually a symbol of the goddess Venus. It's a symbol of love, and they took that because if you look at the strawberry, it kind of looks like a heart. It's also that red color. It's a very seductive type of a fruit, and really reminds us to use that as a symbol to find love within our lives. Sometimes it's about loving ourselves. Sometimes it brings in other people as well, but it's really a symbol also of finding that passion within yourself. So as you're figuring out what you want to do in your life, what direction the universe is taking you, and what types of action you're going to do to determine what you're going to have in the fall, make sure you're in touch with what brings you passion. What excites you? What is your why for what you do? What's the reason that you do what you do? What things do you do every day? Is it a job, or is it people that are in your life? Is it a hobby? What is it that you do with a lot of your time, and what's the reason that you do it? Get in touch with your why so that as you're going through the days, you can find the joy in that. So that sometimes we have to do things that aren't that pleasant, that we don't really like to do, but it's part of getting to the goal that we want. So it's about remembering what your why is. Find your passion. If you're not passionate about what you're doing, if you're not happy with what's going on in your life, then find where your passion is and make changes so that you can be passionate, so you can allow that self-love to really shine through, so you can find that joy, so you can really bring out that strawberry within yourself, that passion within yourself, getting in touch with the Venus within you, using it as a reminder to find your passion in your plans that you're working so hard for. Another really interesting thing with strawberries, so I mentioned there's several different types of strawberries. There's the North American strawberry. I don't remember all the specific names for all of them. They all have their own root names, but there's a European strawberry, there's a South American strawberry. The South American strawberry was actually combined with the European one, which helped to create the strawberries we use a lot now today in the supermarkets, that are these like gigantic looking, to me, kind of weird ones. I like the little ones better, but it was a little comforting to find out that it was actually because they were crossing them with the naturally large ones in South America. I thought they did weird genetic modifications. So anyway, there are a multitude of strawberries, just like there's a multitude of types of people. And there was a brand new strawberry that was just discovered for the first time in 2012. And there's a lot of things that seemed a little significant to me about this one. It was actually discovered in the high mountain Cascades in Oregon by a female scientist, and when they discovered it, they found that this strawberry actually has 10 chromosomes in it, whereas all of the other strawberry varieties that have ever been found thus far have 8 chromosomes in them. So they're not sure exactly why. They don't know if it's the altitude. The strawberry was actually found in the range of about 3,000 to 5,000 feet up in the Cascade Mountains in Oregon. And it's really interesting to me. I do a lot of numerology, and I work with a lot of the vibrations and different frequencies too. So 4,000 is a really significant number, because that's the angel number. That's the vibration that the angels really resonate with a lot, 4,100 hertz. And so the fact that that's right in the middle range of where they found these strawberries that have 2 extra chromosomes that has never been seen before really kind of seems like it might be a great reminder to think about bringing in the higher vibration to your plans and to your passions. And it would be so interesting to see where, if there's a way to get these types of strawberries in our part of the country. But they do grow only so far as they know, in these Cascade Mountains. The altitude matching the frequency of the angels, that 4,000 number, can be a great reminder to really use this time of the strawberry moon, the whole phase. It's not just when the moon is full, it's the whole time from when the moon was new to full, and down to when it, as it wanes and becomes the new moon, which will begin the July moon. So we're going to be in this strawberry phase for another about a week and a half or so after this video. So use that to find your passion. Use this to really kind of maybe even meditate on this new discovery of the strawberry and the strawberry moon and the summer solstice, and find out where your passion is. What lights the fire within you? What gets you excited about life? What makes you want to continue into the next day, the next morning, the next night? And really, maybe if you feel drawn, bring in the frequency of the angels. Ask the angels to help to bring you guidance. Angels are all around us all the time, but we have to ask for them to help us because they respect our free will. So use this beautiful time of the summer solstice to invigorate and awaken your passion, to really take the action to create the life of your dreams. Remember that this is a lot about balance as well. So it's about taking the action and also taking the rest. Sometimes we have things within life that will maybe flip us a little bit from what would normally be where we are in the wheel. You might find that this is a time where the universe is telling you to rest a little bit more. That might be the action that you're supposed to be taking, is to take the time to rest. Sometimes resting is a very active thing because we have so much that goes on in our minds, and there's so much that is replenishing, healing, changing, growing just within our minds, that we need to take this beautiful days of summer to kind of take that time to relax, to rest, recharge, really reinvigorate the batteries, the passion that's within you. Remember the balance. Enjoy the lazy evenings after your fruitful day, and perhaps maybe bring in some strawberries as you're enjoying this time of the strawberry moon. You might even decide that you want to use them to empower your journey. Maybe you want to make a little offering to the fairies outside as you enjoy the strawberries. Whatever works for you with bringing in the light of the sun, really just focus on what brings you passion. Ask that question until you know what your why is. You know what makes you passionate, and you find that joy within your life. I hope this has been an inspiration to you, and I hope you will join us next week here at Earth and Sky. Thank you.